We're looking at part one. Okay, also probability in the mainstream context, they actually teach this in secondary 2 and secondary 4. That's why you see that in your EMF textbook, you will be using two books. One is sec 2, one is sec 4. Because they teach it in two parts. We learn it in all in JH3. They learn it in JH2 and JH4. Okay, also actually, the first one actually is the mainstream. They learn in sec 2, the next part is all in sec 4. Okay, just for your info, Okay, so textbooks that you need to have, we need to have book 2 as well as book 4. Okay? Can I? Okay, so far? Okay, stay. Yeah, okay, so. Hopefully, next time, JH3 classroom can Apple TV. Okay, also, probability of single events, basically, what does probability measure? What do the terms, experiment, sample space, event and outcome mean? What the range of values and probability? Okay, so actually it's quite I'll show you this one, very intuitive topic. Very intuitive because you like to gamble, you like to throw die, you naturally maths will be quite helpful to you lah, huh? Okay, if you watch there are some movies that deals with counting. They use counting basically to help them cheat in gambling. Okay, have you heard of the movie 21? No? Maybe today if you have time, can go and watch the movie. It's a true story about this MIT grad who actually used he count cards. Then he actually won a lot of money at Las Vegas. This one I can show you. Okay. Probability of single events. Okay. Okay. Suppose I select two players. Basically, if you look at probability, it's a chance or a number. The number that you're looking at is between 0 to 1. Between 0 to 1. 0 means that it likely will never happen. 1 will be something like will happen. Okay? So if I throw a 6-sided die at the same time, each die showing a number from 1 to 6. If the larger die is 1, 2, 3, 4, A wins. And the larger number is 5 or 6, like 20. So how do I find, for example, how we calculate probability this way is we look at, we want to use the probability of the event that you want, of A. Alright, how we calculate this probability is basically by counting the number of ways that our event can happen. Okay, so let's say, for example, the event here, let's say if I throw a die, six-sided, fair die, okay, there's no mercury inside, unbiased die, okay, every outcome has an equal chance of happening. Okay, so that basically the number of possible outcomes can be 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5, or 6. Okay, let's say if I say that A means I get an even number, then what's the probability of it? Probability of A basically is the number of ways that A can happen over the total number of ways. Okay, so let me just ask you, at the top, numerator, how many ways can A happen? How many ways can I get an even number? 3. So you see, very intuitive, very clever, I'll just count. 3. How many ways can the total outcomes, how many possible ways are there? 6. So it's actually 1 over. Of course, there's a proper way to write this. Usually probability, we write it as capital P. Okay, P bracket A. Then counting, you remember in sets, your study sets, right? How do we count the number of elements in bracket A over the number of elements in the top of the sample space? Okay, well, there will be some new words that I'll introduce to you. So that's our take it soon. So you see the word sample space, see the word event, you see the word outcome. Okay? Can I? Okay. So let's say you look at class discussion, player A and player B. So 1, 2, 3, 4, player A will win. 5 and 6, player B will win. Who do you think has a higher chance? A. Okay, well, quite obvious because A, you can see the probability of A win. In this case, the probability of A win. It's basically 4 out of 6, which is 4 out of 3. Then the probability that B wins basically is 4 out of 6 and 1 out of 3. Okay, just by counting. counting the number of ways that it can happen over the total number of ways. Okay? Okay, okay, so let's say if you look at some point or another, you come across statements something like this way, like, you know, a chance, something random, yeah, something like there's a chance that it will happen, there's a chance that you will miss, or don't know whether can get to school, or a chance that I'll be late, or a chance that you will rain. Okay, so all these are actually, so for the idea of chance is formalized in mathematics, so under a field of study called probability. Okay, and probability, you will see again, it's under, actually it's under so-called under stats. In senior high, you will study in H2 math. It's one big topic. Okay, so make sure you know this well. Okay? So of course, if I know that since by this definition, right, by this definition, if we are counting the number of ways that something can happen, that's how we do our probability. Then, okay, let's say if I go throw a die, same thing, okay, A is the, now let's say, look at A. A is the event that I get, for example, I get a number, maybe I get a score of 7 to 10 on a single throw. Okay, what is the number of ways that A can happen? Zero. Number of outcomes in the sample says 6. That's why the answer is just 0. Okay, so of course, a probability of 0, you can see it means that it will never happen. Okay, that's why it's 0. Probability of 1 means that it definitely will occur. Okay, example, throw a die, A is the event where I get the score 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. What's the probability of A? 6 over 6. Lah. It's basically 6 over 6. Okay, 6 over 6, in this case, it's just equals to 1. Now because a probability of 1 means that the event definitely will occur. Okay, you don't say 100%, you say probability of 1. Okay, so the higher the probability, the higher the event will occur. Probability usually is always a number between 0 to 1. It's usually a fraction or can be a decimal between 0 to 1. Easy, easy or very boring? Very boring. Okay, I go on. Okay. There's some terminologies. Okay, in probability experiment, it's a process. Okay, you cannot predict the outcome. Okay. So, example, tossing a coin. This is what we call the sample space. So, the sample space basically is like a set containing all the possible outcomes. Okay, so, for example, if I throw a coin, okay, possible outcomes here or there. If I throw a six-sided die, okay, possible outcomes, 6. Okay, usually die, poker cards, spinner are the common questions. They are the common questions. If you look at your notes, if you look at the exam paper, you always ask for this few. Okay, spinner, die, coin. Okay,
So when you see a coin, make sure when the die is a six-sided die, okay, don't assume, okay, there are different kinds of dice as well. Okay, example like this kind, you see? Got 10 sided. I found this at a toy shop. You know, see before? Okay, 12 sided. Okay, okay. 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 Pass it. Okay. 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 So event. Some new words are event. Okay. Event is one or more outcomes which are related in some way. So the event. What's the event? Event is probably of getting a
prime number. Okay. Getting a 2. Okay.
And one more part I want to share is a complement. Yeah, for any event, complement is denoted by E prime. Okay, basically it's where all the outcomes are not in E. Okay, so for example here, if I throw a die, okay. I throw a die, okay, a six-sided die. Then E is the event that I get a number
Where?
Okay. Then E prime basically is the event that I don't get a bunch of numbers. Okay, E prime is basically the event that I do not get a prime. Okay, so E prime, basically prime is just the opposite. Prime is just a complement. Okay, I'll add together, the probability of E and E prime, when you add together, will always give you 1, because they complement each other. Similarly, if I want probability of E prime, I just take 1 minus the probability of E. Okay? There are some common terminology. So you need the word complement. 1.1. Anyone want to see the cards? No. Okay. I just bought in case. These cards are not my confiscated. Okay. So look at question 1.1. Total 6 questions. Okay. If I can request, maybe can I ask you to do this? Okay, maybe write something like then question. Okay, before I let you do the question, okay, very quickly. Commonly you will see playing cards. Okay, playing cards. What? Is it? Okay. If your parents really don't allow you to play cards, then let them know funny math to play a bit of cards. Okay, and then paper sometimes will come out cards. Okay, make sure you know. Yeah, so in due process, I'm going to show you. Okay, in the topic of probability, you will see questions related to playing cards. So make sure you know what the. Anyone here has not played poker cards before? Serious? Elliot? You are don't bluff. Okay, don't believe. Okay, so instead of playing cards, listen carefully. There are 4 suits. 4 suits are like this. Okay, so. There are 4 suits, each suit got 13 cards. There are 4 suits. That's why I took your photo yesterday. Okay. If you're okay with this, okay, that actually is a very easy topic. Let's look at there are 4 suits. Okay? There are 4 suits. Okay? This one is called the Spade. No,
person, okay, no? Go boarding should be initiated, okay. Then for each suit, there are actually 13 cards. So you can see it's all the way, there's an ace, all the way to 10, then jack, queen, and king. Okay, so these three are also called a picture cards.
Okay, so when you buy a type of card, you can buy from that. Chinese people go and play, okay, so there's a lot.
Okay, there are a total of 52 cards. Okay, you do not count the joker. Joker usually people take, they just throw away. Okay, the joker not important, okay? So total you can see 4, each suit got 13. 4 times 13? 52.
Okay, the joker is not counted. Just for laugh, okay. Okay. Yeah? So the joker not counted, okay? Okay. Joking. Joker not counted, okay.